three in a row against the Marlins down in Miami. Sarah Kay, Ernie Acosta on the other side of the glass. The Major League trade deadline, of course, 2 hours to go, 1 hour and 55 minutes, 4 o'clock Eastern is when the deadline is. And we really haven't heard too much today since last night with the trade of Jake Peavy to the Red Sox.
And last night was crazy because you heard throughout the night all these weird things happening with the Red Sox. Like you heard one of their top prospects, Jackie Bradley Jr., who of course was with the team earlier this year, got pulled in the middle of a minor league game. Then a Jose Iglesias gets pinch hit for, so you're thinking, whoa, what's going on here? And the first guess was Cliff Lee, because if they're dealing Jackie Bradley right. Jr., you would think it would be something significant. The Bradley Jr. pull was just a minor injury. The Iglesias pull was for the Jake Peavy trade in what expanded into a three-way trade in which, my opinion, and we'll see what the prospects turn out to be, and we'll see what Peavy does down the stretch, I think was a brilliant trade by Dave Dombrowski and the Detroit Tigers to add not just a shortstop to fill in for Johnny Peralta, who's probably going to be suspended,
yeah,
but probably their shortstop for the next 8 to 10 years. I mean, Iglesias is a legitimate Rookie of the Year candidate. He's hitting .330, plays a very good defensive shortstop when he's played shortstop. And Dombrowski didn't show his cards because for the last few weeks, yeah, they're not looking for a shortstop. You don't hear anything about it. Then he pulls off Iglesias. Now we'll see what Peavy does for the Red Sox. I can't say I hate the trade, but I don't love the trade. Like, getting Cliff Lee, if I'm a Red Sox fan, would get me all giddy. Jake Peavy gets hurt a lot. Pitching in Boston, a lot of pressure, big environment. He's been up and down. I mean, it's an upgrade. I understand that. But it doesn't... I don't go crazy and say it's a slam dunk. I'm going to kill it either, but it's not a slam dunk.
Well, we'll see. I mean, Peavy's been pitching pretty well. I mean, his ERA is over four. The White Sox haven't been very good. I get that. I guess the Buchholz injury factors into this, too, as far as the Red Sox are concerned. So you got to look at that. We'll see. We'll see how it plays out for Boston. We'll see. I don't think it's a terrible move for him. Peavy's a solid, he's a professional pitcher.
Well, like I said, I'm not going to kill it. It's just I'm excited about it more for Detroit than anybody. I think they, at least at first, are the winners. But, hey, the truth is when trades are made, you got to give it like 5 years
right.
Before you know who the winner is.
Right.
We were always trying to analyze that three-way trade between the Yankees, Tigers, and Diamondbacks right from the beginning, the Kennedy, Granderson, Austin, Jackson, Max Scherzer thing. And you really can't. You can't give an answer until years go by because it looked like Arizona did so well when Ian Kennedy had that great year. Now Ian Kennedy looks like he's about to be traded. So
right.
Did the Diamondbacks win the deal? They traded Max Scherzer. Did the Yankees win the deal? At first, Curtis Granderson was fantastic.
Looks like the Tigers are the leader right now.
No question.
I think you have to say that.
Well, today there's no question it's Detroit, but I'll tell you, at first it looked like Arizona did pretty well when Kennedy had that first
great 20 game inning. He won 20 that one year.
Yeah, so sometimes you got to wait a while, but the development with the Yankees is this, and this is according to Mark Feinstein, who just tweeted this maybe about 5 to 10 minutes ago. Michael Young, who you have to think is going to be traded the next 2 hours with the way the Phillies have fallen out of it. But first, the report was he'll only accept a deal to Texas. Then last night it comes out, you know what? He'll accept a deal to Boston. According to Mark Feinstein, now Michael Young would accept a deal to the New York Yankees. So, if in the next hour and 52 minutes, Brian Cashman can work something out with Philadelphia, Young reportedly will not block a trade to the New York Yankees.
All right,
so that's a development right there.
That is a development, no doubt. And hopefully, we'll have Brian. We're trying to get Brian Cashman and Sandy Alderson today, right after the deadline is over. So to talk about what they did or did not do. So we'll try to get both of those on. We will have Terry Collins with us today in his regular spot at 5:05. I think we got Peter Gammons coming on as well, right, today?
Indeed.
And so you got a lot of this going on.
Speaking of Ian Kennedy, the reports are he's very close to being traded inside the division to the San Diego Padres in a trade, which is fascinating if you think about it, because Arizona's obviously in it, but they're probably pretty down on Ian Kennedy. And I always thought, one thing about that three-way trade, the Yankee-Diamondback-Tiger trade, that you can judge it based on Austin Jackson. I totally get that. And I understand a Yankee fan saying they shouldn't have done just the Jackson-Granderson swap. I never felt Ian Kennedy was going to work with the New York Yankees. So even that 21 year he had with the Diamondbacks, I never looked at it as, oh my God, they gave up on Ian Kennedy. I never felt that Ian Kennedy was ever going to work with the Yankees. Remember he had some run-ins with the media and all that?
Yep.
Made some comments after bad performances. And look at the way Ian Kennedy has fallen after that big year he had.
Yeah, you're right. Look, I mean,
And another thing, too, I mean, the Yankees have never been a great place for a young pitcher. I mean, I know Nova's kind of flourishing right now. He's pitched pretty well. But, I mean, they've never really been a great landing spot for young pitchers over the years.
You know, it's tough to develop young pitchers when you're in a...
constantly a now team.
Yeah, when you're in a win-now mentality, which the Yankees have. And speaking of the Yankees last night, there was one big positive that came out of their loss to the L.A. Dodgers, and that was Andy Pettitte. Andy Pettitte, who looked very shaky in the first couple of innings. Ernie Acosta even tweeted to me and said, boy, Andy continues to show batting practice. Well, you know what Andy did? He kept them in the game. And if the Yankee offense was able to figure anything out against Zach Greinke in the Dodger bullpen, Andy gave him a chance to win the game. But it came down to the same problem, Joe, we've talked about for months now. They didn't score enough
runs. That's definitely true. We also got a little help from a great throw. I just saw it now from Ichiro throwing. I think it was Hanley Ramirez out at the plate. That was a big play.
That was a tremendous throw by Ichiro.
It really was.
Look, Ichiro's a 280 hitter. He's still a solid player. Can still steal some bases. One aspect where he has not lost anything is that arm in right field.
Nope.
And that was a big play early in the game because, like I mentioned, Andy was really struggling early, and the Dodgers had opportunities to put some more runs up on him, but he was able to get through with the help of Ichiro, gave him seven strong. And look, Zach Greinke's a good pitcher. It's not like they got shut down by Joe Nobody.
Right.
Zach Greinke is solid, but Joe, five hits, two runs, it ain't going to win you a lot of games.
Well, look, I mean, who gave us the stat yesterday? Somebody gave us this. I can't remember who it was, but the Yankees
Joel
record.
Sherman.
Yeah, Joel Sherman. At the Yankee record in games where they have scored two runs or less is 3-33. Now 3-34.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, it's not happening. You know, that's been the problem all year, their lack of offense.
Look,
no doubt.
I know we'll at some point get back to A-Rod and all the steroid stuff, but I think last night they do get Jason Nix back, and Jason Nix had played well for a while, but the facts are the facts. He's at 230 this season. Michael Young, especially considering, you would think they're not going to have to give up that much to get him.
No. How old is he? 35, 36?
He's up there, but he's also a free agent at the end of the year,
right.
So this is a short-term thing. Assuming they don't have to give up anything significant, Michael Young is such a nice acquisition for the Yankees for a few reasons. Not only can he play third base, because I think the fair assumption is they're not going to have Alex, but he can play first base, and he gives you that versatility of playing those two positions. I know he's an older guy. I get that. You want the Yankees to get younger. The problem is, right before the trade deadline, you're not going to get younger. You know, you're not finding a good young player to help you before the deadline. The odds are. So you have to bring in a veteran like this. And I think Michael Young's a good fit for the Yankees. We've talked about it for a while. And now the fact that he's okay with the trade to the Yankees, we'll see if Brian can pull it off in the next hour 45 because they still need help offensively.
No, there's no doubt.
Even with Alfonso Soriano at a double yesterday, they still need help offensively. They just still don't score enough runs.
Bottom line, no question about it.
And how are they going to score runs tonight?
Against Kershaw?
Yeah.
Maybe that game might be nothing into like the 12th inning or something like that with Corona and Kershaw going at it.
Hey, this is where the final score is 13-11. Something like that.
yeah, maybe.
I doubt it.
Has he given up 11 runs all year, Kershaw?
No.
I didn't think so.
All season combined?
I don't know.
I think it gets
close.
But tonight is really an appealing matchup because Corona, and we say this every 5 days, he's been such a good New York Yankee. And maybe it goes unnoticed because he hasn't gotten a lot of run support, and the Yankees haven't been like an all-world team in the last year and a half, but we did get to an ALCS last year. But Oroki Corona's got a 2.51 ERA in the American League East. I mean, think about that for a second. How good is that?
Yeah, he's been great. Yeah, like I said, he's been their most valuable player. He's been outstanding.
Yeah, and he's clearly been their ace. As CC has fallen off, Corona's taken the mantle. And then you got Kershaw. And... look, I know Clayton Kershaw can go out and pitch a complete game shutout tonight. A lot of Yankee fans are going to say, see, our offense stinks. But you know what? Clayton Kershaw could probably shut anybody out right now. You could take an all-star lineup and put it against this guy.
ERA is 1.96, so, I mean, you can't do a heck of a lot better than that.